is the National Day of Prayer. We come here every year so that we can pray collectively as a people. But the topic and the theme for today is Wake Up America. And when I saw this topic, I said to myself, I gotta talk on this one. Because it reminds me of a young man by the name of Samson, that he fell asleep on the lap of a woman named Delilah. You see, Samson was a child of God, and God had a work for him to do. You see, Delilah loved Samson, but there was something Delilah loved more than Samson, and that was money. And she said, Samson, tell me where your strength is. But Samson kept on playing around. You see, America, many nations wanted to know where our strength is. We've been a nation that's been strong. We've been a nation that's been prosperous. We've been a nation that's been growing stronger. And people want to know what makes America strong. And finally, Samson got tired and said, if you cut my hair, I will lose my strength and be like anyone else. And he fell asleep on Delilah's lap. I believe America revealed to the world that their strength is in God.
Amen. Preach,
and
preacher,
their strength
preach.
Is in their commitment and dedication and consecration to God. But the system of the world said, won't you lay down, America, and fall asleep on my lap. And while Samson was asleep on Delilah's lap, she cut his hair. Now, long hair on a man then was worn in seven tails. And I believe America is asleep on Delilah's lap, and the hair is being cut. The first braid is the braid of prayer. They snatched it off. They took prayer out of the school while America was sleeping. They took away holiness while America was sleeping. They cut off morality while America was sleeping. You see, Samson, you need to wake up, because Delilah is cutting your hair. If America don't wake up soon, she will find herself bald and naked. She's going to find herself, when Samson got up and she said, the Philistines upon you, Samson. Samson said, I will arise as I have done at other times and shake myself. Why is it that the people that lost their power are the last ones to know? You think you're still looking good, honey. You think you're still pretty at 103. Oh, America, we're sitting blind and naked, and we done got stripped of our power, and we still think we all right with God. You better wake up, America. Jesus Christ is on his way back. We as a nation need to arise. We need to wake up out of our sleep. We need to realize that the devil is cutting the hair on America. He's trying to get us to conform to be like everybody else, when God said, come out from among them and be ye separate, says the Lord. The Bible said, if my people, which are called by my name, if we will humble ourselves and pray, seek my face and turn from our wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins and heal the land. Wake up, America. You see, we wake folks up when they slept enough. We wake folks up when they're falling asleep. Have you ever been driving in your car and been super tired and you falling asleep at the wheel? And you'll be nodding and you'll be wondering, did I go to sleep or not? I can't remember, but many folks have died falling asleep at the wheel. Who's driving the car of America right now? Because we're sleeping at the wheel. We done hit the bumps on the roads trying to warn us. You're getting too close to the curb. Wake up, America. But America needs not to wake up on its own. The people in America got to wake up. The families in America got to wake up. The businesses in America got to wake up. For God will live, for God will die. Wake up, America. We got to wake up. People say, Pastor, don't take all that. Honey, it takes this and more. It takes this and more. We need to know who we are and whose we are. And we can't do it asleep. There's a sign that people say when they fall asleep on the job, the employer placed a sign that says, you don't have a job when you wake up. America won't have a nation when she wakes up. We done given it away. We have allowed things in the door of America that's never been allowed before in the word of conformity. But I'm not here to conform, honey. The Bible said, be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you might prove that was good, perfect, and acceptable will of God. I don't want to be conformed, but I do want to be transformed. Oh, that I'm transformed from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light. I want to be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, but I got to get up about what the Father wants me to do. Oh, church people, I'm sorry. Oh, I feel like I'm at church. We got to wake up. We can't conform. We can't give up. We can't give in to the world system. What was sin then is still sin now. What was wrong then is still wrong now. Wake up, America. Don't you give in. Don't you give up. Don't think that you're the only one. When Elijah was there, he said, what you doing in the cave? He said, God, they killed all your prophets, and I'm the only one left. God said, I got over 700 that have never kissed the ring of Baal nor bowed the knee. Wake up, America. You are not alone. God said, I'll never leave you, never forsake you. I'm with you always. We got to wake up. We got to wake up our neighbors. We got to wake up our neighbors. We got to be willing to stand up and show them I'm not only a Christian, I'm a child of the Most High God. I walk like him. I talk like him. I act like him. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Oh, too many churches are having religious service. Too many churches are entertaining in the building. We don't need entertainment. We need salvation. We don't need entertainment. We need Jesus Christ. Oh, we don't need programs. We don't need clubs and committees. We need a move of the Holy Ghost. Y'all might not invite me back, but I'm the president. Oh, and I'm saying we need to wake up. Because time is running out. And the Bible says that all the nations that forget God are cast into hell. Oh, wake up, America. Because Delilah is cutting your hair. Wake up, America, because you don't have the strength you used to have. Wake up, America, because you have conformed to the standards of the world. Oh, everything that was sin, we're letting it in now. We don't want to be politically correct, but I'd rather be spiritually correct. I don't need political. I need spiritual. I need to realize it don't matter what men say, but it does matter what my God says. Oh, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you. Thy word got to be a lamp unto my feet. Thy word, we need a word of God. We don't need all songs. We don't need more praise. We need a word of God, not only on the outside, but down in our heart. If you let this word get inside of you.
Yes. Amen.
Yeah, I'm Pentecostal. We need a move of God. We don't need religion. We need Jesus. We need Jesus. People of Victoria, wake up. Because sooner or later, you're going to wake up and it's going to be too late, huh? It'll be too late. You will find yourself crashing into the wall of trouble. And then when it's time to call on God, it'll be too late. Let not America stay asleep. Let her get on up. That we might be the people of God. God never called the most popular. God never called you to be the most liked. But God did call the church to speak the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. We must speak what the word says. Yes, but Brother Green, you fail to understand they'll close down your business when you try to sell. When you try to don't do it their way, when you don't give up, don't give in, honey, it don't matter. This world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. My treasure should be laid up somewhere beyond the blue. I heard the angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I'm waking up because I'm getting ready to take off. I don't know how I'm going to get there. Might be by an airplane. Might be by on the subway. But the songwriter said, I don't care how you get here, long as you get here fast as you can. Oh, I'm waiting on the Lord because we're not going to be here always. We're not going to go through this always. We are the church of the Most High God. The world don't have nothing on you. Don't think the world got more things on you. We serve a God that can do anything but fail. He said, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard? Wake up, America. Amen. Y'all can keep Obama. Y'all can keep Donald Trump. You can keep Hillary. I'll take Jesus, and that's enough. I got Jesus, and that's enough. If they close down my business because I refuse to have more than 2 restrooms, let them close it down. If they take down my bakery shop because I only want to do what Jesus said, let them take it. Because there's a supper table waiting for me on the other side of glory. I'll get down to sit down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and tell them how I made it over. Oh, don't cry for me. Don't worry about me. We're not here to be politically correct. We're here to be the strong families of Victoria. Let's be the people that God has called, and let's wake up. Wake up. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Wake up. Wake up. Neighbor. Wake up. Let's give God some praise. Come on.